Hello everyone, this is Rex from Nova Custom, and today I've got a new video for you on how to install Windows 11 in VirtualBox by using Ubuntu as your host operating system. I will not only guide you through the steps to install Windows 11, but I will also show you how to set up bidirectional copy-paste, the shared folders functionality and USB pass-through support. This is actually to get the best out of VirtualBox. So let's get started. The first thing we want to do is fully upgrading your system with this command. As you can see, our computer is fully up to date. Now let's install VirtualBox with the following command. And we confirm our action by pressing I and enter. Meanwhile, we can download the ISO file that we'll need to install Windows 11 in our VirtualBox. To do so, search online for Windows 11 ISO and navigate to the first search result. You will see the blue page of Microsoft where you can download your ISO file. If you scroll a little bit down, the download might take a while. For the installation of VirtualBox extension pack, you will need to accept the license. Open VirtualBox after the installation. Now create a new VirtualBox. Give it a name, whatever you would like, and check if other settings are okay for you. As for the memory size, we recommend you to increase the amount of memory unless you have 8 GB of memory on your computer or even less. We recommend 8 GB of memory for your VirtualBox. We now have to set up a virtual hard drive. You can keep all default settings except the size of the drive. 80 GB might be too low, so let's set up 250 GB as our virtual hard drive is dynamic anyway, so it doesn't actually take 250 GB of your internal hard drive. Okay, we've now set up our virtual box and we want to change some settings. Go to System and then increase the amount of processes to the very right side of the green bar. Do the same for your video memory under the display settings, but enable 3D acceleration first. That's it, let's start up our brand new VirtualBox. The box asks to boot to an ISO file immediately, so select your ISO file, which is probably in the downloads folder. If you see a shell like this, simply enter exit and boot to the ISO file you just selected. You will need to press a key to boot from CD or DVD, which is basically your Windows 11 ISO file in our case. So please do so and wait for the setup program to be booted. Select your preferences and click Next. Fill in your product key here if you have one, or just click I don't have a product key. In this case, you can simply add it later. Now select your Windows version. As you can see, we don't meet the minimum requirements for Windows 11. This is because we are trying to install Windows 11 within a VirtualBox. This VirtualBox doesn't support TPM and Secure Boot yet, which is an official requirement for Windows 11. However, we can bypass this error by hitting Shift plus F10. We now get a CMD prompt and we can open our registry editor with the command regedit. We go to hkey local machine, system, setup, and create a new key. Call it labconfig with capital letter L and C. Create a new 32-bit dboard value in this folder called bypass secure boot jack. Please check the spelling and the capital letters. Set its value to 1. Create another 32-bit dboard value and call it bypass TPM check. Select set its value to 1 as well. Now close the registry editor and the setup and try again. The error no longer shows up. You'll now come to the point where you have to select if you want to upgrade your installation or set up a new installation. We'll obviously proceed with the custom installation of Windows. We select our virtual hard drive and we click Next. Windows is installing now. Before Windows is actually booted for the first time, you will really need to disable all your internet connections. This is because Windows 11 doesn't allow you to set up Windows 11 with a local account that is not connected with a Microsoft account, unless no internet connection is active and a workaround is being applied. As you can see in the right upper corner, I enabled flight mode to make sure no internet connection is active. The installation of Windows 11 might take a while, so this is a good point to walk to your coffee machine and enjoy your coffee. You will see this screen as soon as Windows 11 has booted for the first time. You won't be able to proceed without a Microsoft account and without an internet connection. So again, we will bypass this with Shift plus F10, which will open a CMD prompt. You might need to select a CMD window with Alt plus Tab. And we've now filled in OOBE/bypass nro.cmd. And we confirm it with Enter. This will reboot your computer, applying the settings for creating an offline account, provided that no internet connection was found yet. See here, there is an option now for I don't have internet. If you don't have this option, you either had a working internet connection at the time Windows was booting for the first time, or you didn't run bypass nro command. We don't recommend you to do so, but if you want, you can proceed with your Microsoft account. Now continue with setting up Windows 11. Please make sure you disable all privacy sensitive settings, as we do so in our video. You can use the Tab and Space key or the Enter key to select different options. Windows now locked you in, as you can see, but we need to set up quite some more things. The first thing we want to do is fully updating Windows. You will need to recover your internet connection for this, and it is safe to do so now. While the updates are running, let's set up Microsoft Edge. You know, that ugly web browser of Microsoft. Make sure to get rid of all the Bing crap like we do in this video. Do some more personalization options in this video. This is to increase the performance, security and privacy. Feel free to check them out and apply them as well, or apply your own preferences. We'll be right back. Now it's time to install the guest additions pack. This is to make it possible to use the shared clipboard and the drag and drop functionality, which is really useful. In the menu of VirtualBox, go to Devices and click on Insert Guest Additions CD Image and click on Download. Click on Download again and wait for the download to be completed. Now click Insert. Navigate to this PC and you'll see a virtual CD drive that contains the installation files for the guest additions. Run the file VBox Windows Additions by double clicking it and select Yes. Go through the installation wizard. Reboot Windows 11 after the installation. Our VirtualBox is now running with the extensions pack, meaning the screen resolution of the box is responsive and always full size. We can now enable drag and drop and the shared clipboard functionality. I will show you now that it works. We can now also set up a shared folder between Ubuntu and Windows. From my experience, sharing the downloads folder is quite useful, but you can share any other folder if you want so. Select the folder you want to share and make sure the settings are the same as in this video. Click on OK and OK again and you will see the shared folder under this PC. As you can see, it's the same folder as the downloads folder of Ubuntu. We have one more thing to set up, which is USB pass-through. This makes sure USB devices can work in Windows. This is not possible by default, so you have to enable it. To do so, you will need to power off your VirtualBox and open a terminal. Then fill in these commands. After that, you'll need to reboot your computer. So add the host operating system, which is Ubuntu. Now that the computer has restarted, I will show you that it's possible to forward any USB device to the VirtualBox. We can insert a USB pen drive and we will start VirtualBox. Please wait for Windows until you are fully logged in. Now, right-click on the USB icon and click the USB device you want to pass through. And voila, there it is! You can do the same thing to bring the USB device back to Ubuntu. That's it guys, I hope you can now enjoy your Windows installation in VirtualBox. If you do so, please like this video. It's good to know that Nova Custom sells Linux laptops with VirtualBox pre-installed, so check it out in the description. Please don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thanks again and see you in the next video.